So let's see, the seven negotiates in the track. Trichers. Oops. That's interesting. Yes, the bright orange level really makes things wash out. Use the level to make sure the track's mostly flat. I shimmed up that low spot. We'll see if it's enough. And the reversing move in the other direction. See how this goes. Oops. He picked the switch. Wonder why. Oh. I threw the switch, the points came unsoldered right here. So I'm gonna have to resolder that right. But I can't do that right now because soldering iron's not plugged in. We'll just reverse move through the standard direction. So it goes that way. Bar's looking good. Oh. Tricking that switch again. Low spot must still be too low. One of the things I like about the Intermountain cars, they're finicky. They're heavy for a tanker, but they let me know if I have track work issues I need to solve. They're really good at it. And what's hanging up now? Good question, huh? Boxcar. I'm on to fuss with when I do those points. And let's drive through the other direction. For squeaky floors. This is an older MDC roundhouse mogul. With an NCE chip in it. I really like them. The locomotives, chips work pretty good too. I got a lot of motor control. Adjustments. This guy's maximum speed is set at about 30. Don't know what he stalled for, just because he wanted to be. Ooh. The boxcar picked another point. I wonder what's going on there. I'll back it up and see. I'll have to adjust that point a little bit. It's not quite. focus in on it, but this point here, zoomed out too far. There we go. Anyway, this point right here, not quite in contact with the rail. I'll have to tweak that a little tiny bit. Handy dandy pointy screwdriver and needle nose. Twist the spring tension here. Just a little bit when I find my tweezers. It's a two-handed thing to tweak the tension on the controls or linkage. Bending on the point and just a tiny bit of filing on it, it sticks up a little bit, taper it down just a smidgen. We'll see how that works this time around. Hopefully you can see all of that. We'll see if it made any difference. Tiny little tweaks is sometimes all it takes. Oops, and I got another switch to tweak on. It needs a little point fine tuning. Grab my soldering iron, it's still not hot, so we're not going to tune that one. I'll see if I can zoom in on it for you though. Most points don't contact correctly. We'll try this and see. You can see right here it's thrown this way. This is not in contact and this is not gapping up, so do a little adjustment. There we go with that. We'll try backing this guy out of here. See what he does. Doing okay. Getting better. We'll do a throw switch. Putting in code 40. Those of you not knowing, this rail here is code 40 rail as well as this one. Everything else is 55. Code 40 transition is right there where all the solder glob is. Did not make a pretty transition. Code 40 rail is kind of finicky. A lot less jumpy on that switch now. Make sure everything's lined up proper. Do a backing move. Do the other coil before you talk. Dust monkeys underneath the caboose and the gondola are dry. They're just picking up dust and wiping the track. I've put CRC 226 on them before, and it sticks pretty well, so that went pretty well. Dust monkeys work pretty well keeping the track just maintenance wise clean. Well, there we go. We're getting better and better. We'll keep tweaking on it. Pretty soon we'll have a yard full of trains. Doing the work with the trains they're supposed to do. See y'all later.